Listen, thanks for the car. Now, you sure you don't need it?
No, no, I'm going to be stuck here all day.
Okay.
Oh, wait! What? Don't forget the keys.
Oh.
Okay, I'll see you on 6.
5:30. So, new customer relations policy, huh?
That's very funny. No, that was just Josh. He's an old friend.
Really? An old friend who you're helping find his tonsils?
He's an old boyfriend, Joe. We dated in high school, and he's at Harvard getting his MBA. There. Now you have something for your column. I am going to work.
Ooh, Harvard boy. Say no more.
Wait, what's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
I'm sorry, Joe. Not everyone can go to a school whose motto is lefty loosey, righty tighty.
Hey, don't knock Trenton Tech, all right? That was the best 8 weeks of my life.
Yeah, well, I'm sure Josh is going to say the very same thing about his 6 years at Harvard.
Oh, they kept him back? I hear it's a hard school.
Joe, he was summa cum laude. That means top of his class.
Master brake technician, all right?
You are impossible.
So, you guys still dating?
Yeah, we have a long-distance relationship, but that could all be changing because he's having some very big meetings in town.
You have a big weekend plan with the suit, huh?
Yeah, actually I do, but it's nothing I feel like discussing with the robe.
I was just wondering how come you never talked about him before, that's all.
I don't know, Joe. Maybe for the same reason I never talked to you about Molière or Flaubert or Kierkegaard.
Do you ever date any American guys? Been a long time out of touch, but in the end it don't mean much. I am still connected to you. Hey, you've been out there on your own.
Matt, they've invented something to help you do that now. Scientists are calling it the towel.
Oh, yeah? Well, yesterday in biology, we saw pictures of everyday stuff under a microscope. Towels are like country clubs for germs. Look at him, Mom. He's disgusting. He's always pulling stuff out of his nose, his ears. Look, wiping it on his shirt. He's like a third base coach.
That's my napkin.
Excuse me, Mom. I have to go wash my hands.
I love doing that.
Morning.
Whoa, look at you.
Yeah, I've been doing some thinking.
Well, that may be a special occasion, but I don't think it requires a tie.
You're just not used to seeing me in an executive capacity, that's all. You don't have to go to Harvard to build a business. Anyway, I'm going to drop by some companies today and make a pitch. Try to put a face in the name Roman Customizing.
You think that'll work?
Well, we are talking about this face. Just leave it to me.
That's why he's Joe Roman Executive.
I like that.
Matt, have some pancakes.
Do you have any idea how many germs might be on those pancakes?
Well, my recipe calls for 2 million. I like them fluffy. Now eat.
That's my fork. Never gets old.
Lloyd? Lloyd? Lloyd!
Please don't shout, Claire. For some reason, I got a splitting headache.
How's it going? We guaranteed Mr. Foley to have the car by the end of the day. If it isn't ready, we are going to have to do quite a little tap dance.
Really? I would have offered him a rental car, but you're the boss.
I just put Roman Customizing on the map.
Good. That'll make it easier for me to find this place in the morning.
No, I paid a little call to Lezebnik Limos and met with Harvey Lezebnik.
Harvey Lezebnik? The limo king himself?
Yes. Now look, he's going to drop off 6 cars. If we can customize them all by Monday morning, we will be handling his entire fleet.
You know, that's an awfully big job for us, Joe.
Yeah, I know. Anyway, he's going to call and set up a real good drop-off time for us.
He already did. I told him we couldn't handle it.
What? Claire, I can't believe this. I bring in one customer who can double our volume, and you just tell him to take a hike?
Look, I am all for building up the business, Joe, but doing it intelligently.
Oh, so what are you saying, that I'm too stupid to actually build the business?
No, that's not
at all. Let me just tell you something. This stupid guy is the one who actually does all the work around here. And I think I'm a heck of a lot better judge of what we can handle than someone who sits in an office and pushes paper.
So I'm just pushing paper.
I own a quarter of this business, okay? And I'd like to see it grow.
Well, I own the other three quarters, so should we take a vote now?
Fine. Fine, you win. But the business loses.
No, no, this hasn't been too annoying all the way home.
Mom, come on, make him stop.
What is he doing?
I don't know, he won't talk. He just clucked all the way home.
Andy! Andy, the cluck stops here.
I gotta practice. I'm gonna be a chicken soon.
Oh, yeah?
Why are you gonna be a chicken?
This is ridiculous. Please be advised, your son Andy has been exposed to chickenpox and should be monitored for...
Oh my God! Oh God, run for your lives!
Dr. Gannon says chickenpox are nothing to worry about. You're gonna get red spots all over your body and your head may hurt.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Cut to the chase. When do I turn into a chicken?
Oh, sweetie, chickenpox is just a name. You're not gonna turn into a chicken.
Don't sugarcoat it, Mom. I can handle it.
In that case, kid, you'll be sprouting feathers by Thursday.
You're not losing a son, Mom. You're just gaining a freak of nature.
Are you sure you've had the chickenpox before?
Oh, yeah. I remember every itching minute of them. Believe me, I'm bulletproof.
Well, I think I'm going to have to be spending some more time up here.
That's okay. You take care of Annie, and I'll take care of the garage, if you think I can handle it.
I know you can handle it. In fact, Matt hasn't had the chickenpox yet, so I was kind of wondering if he could bunk downstairs with you.
How did Matt get through life without having the chickenpox?
Matt was always a very clean kid. At 1 and a half, he learned how to change his own diaper.
You're making that up, right?
Matt, are you ready to go downstairs?
Oh, my God.
Hey, I saw Outbreak. I know how these things spread.
Look, I'm going to put Andy to bed, and then I'll just be down in a minute. Poor baby, just the thought of how uncomfortable he's going to be is making my skin itch, too. What?
How should I say this? Claire, if I were you, I wouldn't be taking any calls from Colonel Sanders. Harvey, yeah. I signed all the contracts. Yeah, they look pretty standard. Why do we change our minds? Let's just say that my associate misunderstood. Yeah, don't worry about it. All the cars will be ready on Monday morning. You just have that check, okay? All right, bye. There you go.
Thank you for using Captain Speedy's delivery service.
Note to self, don't use Captain Speedy.
Hey, sorry I'm late.
Yeah, you know, you should have been back from lunch about 2 hours ago. What'd you do, park your car in Harvard Yard?
No, Claire told me I could take my time. It's not like we've been busy.
Well, guess what? We are now. Both Claire and Andy had the chickenpox and I'm in charge.
Oh, that's terrible.
Well, it's just the chickenpox.
That's not the part I was talking about.
Joe, we don't have the right air filters for these limos.
Okay, I'll order some more.
Wait, I thought Claire turned that limo job down.
Well, she did, but she's sick and I'm in charge. I had to make an executive decision. Now, can you please get to work? The work that you should have started about 2 hours ago?
Isn't there a small country in South America you should be running?
Look, can we please just get to work and cut the song and dance?
But I've been practicing so hard.
Look, as it is right now, we're going to have to work all weekend just to get this work done.
Oh, wait, not me. I'm not working all weekend. I have plans with Josh, remember? I told you, it's important to me.
Well, Lou, this is important to me. Hey, look, this garage might be a Fortune 500 company, but as long as I'm running it, it has to function like a well-oiled machine.
Well, I can see who's going to be the dipstick. What are you trying to prove?
Look, I don't have to prove anything to anybody. You don't want to come in? Fine. Lloyd, will you please come in this weekend?
Sure, boss. I hate the new boss. He's the most demanding choreographer I've ever had.
look, if you really need me this weekend...
Hey, you and Josh made plans. That's obviously more important to you than Roma customizing. You've made your choice.
Fine.
Fine.
Feel me. What? Feel me, am I warm?
Get lost.
Well, at least let me feel you for comparison.
How will you get out of here? I have a lot of work that I have to do.
Well, maybe I could help you.
Yeah, sure, Matt. Can you rewire an interior?
No.
Blow out a carburetor?
No.
Tune an engine?
No.
Can you tell the difference between a car and a bus?
Of course I can.
Oh, great, great. Take the bus, go to the store, and buy your mom these groceries. Thank you.
First Andy, then Mom. I wonder who's next. It's like we're living an outbreak and our little brother's the monkey. Yeah. What's that red spot on your face?
Oh, Matt. I think it's got me too, buddy. This is it, man. This is just goodbye. Because it's
sauce from the pizza. That's not funny, Joe.
Tell me you're not doing what I think you're doing.
I'm folding my socks.
In anticipation of throwing them in the hamper?
Look, Tom, this is a very small space, and we're in it until the epidemic is over. It wouldn't kill you to be a little neater.
You're right, Matt. It's a good thing that you're tidying up. Makes up for the fact that I forgot to get fresh-cut flowers.
What are you doing? Getting into bed.
Yeah? This is my bed. There's a sleeping bag on the floor for you.
The floor's drafty, Joe. If I get sick, I'll be of no help to you.
You're no help to me now.
Oh, my God. There is a bag of corn chips in your bed.
I take that back. You are helping me out. Just stay on your side of the bed, all right?
You know, I really wish I could give you a hand with those limos.
You know, I don't see how you can live over a garage your whole life and not know how to fix a car.
It's not my fault, Joe. Every time I try to learn, Dad would tell me it's more important than going and do my homework. He wanted me to go to a good college.
Just going to show the old man cared about you, that's all.
Yeah. He did have this dream. He wanted me to be the first Roman to go to Harvard. Oh!
Pardon me, would you happen to have any Grey Poupon?
For the ninth time today, no. Now get out of there. Come on, man. Lloyd, we have to focus. If we get this Lizemnik account, we'll be at the big leagues. We'll be able to expand, hire some employees, go public. You'll just be able to sit back and cash in your stock options, pal, because we'll be rich.
It's all well and good, but how'll I know who my real friends are, huh? I mean, how'll I know who'll love me for me and not for my money? I'd be besieged by hangers-on, willing to do anything to get a piece of millionaire playboy Lloyd Burwell. Big busted floozies, pampering me, shower me with kisses, not because of who I am on the inside, but because of the silver jingle jangle in my pockets. Let's get to work.
That's my man.
Joe, one thing, with Lou gone, there's no way we're gonna get these cars done by Monday.
Yeah, well, she had something more important to do, but don't worry about it. I'm gonna take care of it right now. Yeah, Mr. Lizemnik, please. Harvey, Joe Roman, listen, I'm gonna need one more day with those limousines. Really? It's no problem? Right, clause 72. All right, we'll see you. Bye. Said it's no problem, it happens all the time.
Yeah, no problem for him. According to this, starting Monday morning, 9 a.m., if these limos aren't ready, we're renting them. Clause 72, Joe.
What? Oh, my God, for 120 bucks an hour.
You must be a big executive, Joe. You're renting a fleet of limousines.
We got some bad news, buddy.
What? The stock market has crashed. My financial empire lies in ruins at my feet. I'll be the laughing stock of Wall Street. I'll have to return to my humble beginnings as a mechanic. What? No work? Don't you remember me? Pencil, mister. Pencil, mister. Anyone? Anyone? Once I built a railroad, made it run, made it race against time. Once I built a railroad, now it's done. Brother, can you spare a dime?
He's acting crazy, Joe. Even for Lloyd.
Hey, Lloyd, man, you are burning up, buddy.
Lloyd, listen to me. This is really important. Did you have the chicken pox when you were a kid?
Yes. Every Sunday. Delicious, wholesome chicken pox pie.
Oh, my God! Now it's got Lloyd!
Andy, what are you doing, bud?
Mom, what does it look like I'm doing? I'm scratching.
Andy, don't do that.
It's kind of hard not to.
All right, come here, buddy. Sit down. I think that this will help.
I think this turning into a chicken thing is overrated.
I have to tell you, Andy, I am very proud of you. You're not whining or complaining to your mom. You're being a very good boy. You're being very brave, actually. Well, you know, for a chicken.
Now that's funny.
Here, buddy, look. I want you to put these socks on your hands. That way you won't be able to scratch yourself. And you can put on a puppet show anytime you want, all right? Now, I'll go make you some oatmeal.
Pinstripe and detail all the...
God.
I'm dead. What are you doing?
Number 6 on your list, refilling the brake fluid.
Yeah, that's great, except that's where the power steering fluid goes. Now I'm gonna have to drain it.
I was just trying to help, Joe.
Look, you've helped enough, okay? Maybe Dad was right. Just go do your homework. Damn.
Hey. You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just did something stupid, that's all.
Oh, geez, is it 10:30 already?
Very funny.
Oh, come on, Roman. Where's your sense of humor, huh? Look, I thought you might be hungry. I brought you food.
The Britain House. Very fancy.
Yeah, well, Josh got a job, so we were out celebrating.
Oh, that's great.
Listen, why don't you come and join us for drinks? You know, I think you and Josh would really like each other.
I don't think so. I have a lot of work to do here, and believe it or not, Lloyd got the chicken pox as well.
Oh, poor Lloyd. Listen, do you need help?
So, what are we doing?
Oh, Josh. This is Joe. Joe, this is Josh.
Hi.
Very nice to meet you.
Are you going to be able to finish?
I have to. It's in my contract.
Penalty clause, right?
Yeah, right. Buried in the fine print.
It's a rookie mistake. You saved $200 on a lawyer, but... Cost you $2,000 in the back end.
No, this is not going to cost me anything. I'm going to have to work a couple extra hours, but I'm definitely going to make it.
Well, good.
Yeah. Oh, it was nice to meet you. I got to get back.
You too.
Do you want me to stay?
No. I'm fine. You guys go have fun, honest.
Okay. Well, good night.
Night.
Matt.
What?
Maddie.
What?
Sorry I made you feel stupid just now, right? If you really want to learn about cars, I can definitely teach you.
Yeah, I'd like that. When?
How about now?
I thought I heard someone out here.
Hey, just making a pot of coffee. What are you doing up so late?
I've been sleeping all day. This is the first time in a year I've actually had some rest.
You know, I never realized how much work you actually do around here.
Thanks, Joe. You know, being sick got me thinking. If something should ever happen to me...
Claire, it's just a chicken pox.
No, I mean if something should ever really happen to me. Would you take care of the boys?
What?
I want to name you their legal guardian. I realize it's a lot to ask, but I know I can trust you.
No, you can't. After you got sick, I called Lizevnik and told him that we do the limos.
Oh, Joe, you didn't.
Yeah. There was a penalty clause in the contract that I overlooked, and Matt and I have been working all night, but we're not going to make it.
I don't believe it. My Matt worked on the cars?
Yeah. Anyway, I'm so sorry that I let you down.
Oh, Joe, you didn't let me down. Not where it counts. You know, even though you've only been here a couple of months, I don't even know how I ever got along without you.
I still screwed up.
You made a mistake. So we all do. There's still nobody I'd rather have take care of Matt and Andy. So would you do that for me?
You know I will.
Thank you.
Hey, Matt, your mom was up, man. So she's gonna make us a pot of coffee.
Matt went to wash up.
What a surprise.
Joey does it all the time.
No, I meant you.
Oh, me. Well, I just decided to come to work a little early.
8 hours early? And that's okay with Josh?
Josh will get over it. One of the things he has to learn is that I do what I want to do.
Hey, Lou. Thanks for coming in. I really appreciate it.
See, now you're beginning to sound like a boss.
I hope so. Claire just gave me a really big promotion.
Oh, congratulations. Come on, let's get to work.
Right. Once I built a railroad, made it run, made it race against time.
Once I built a railroad, now it's done. Brother, can you spare a dime?
Lizebnik, Joe Roman. Yeah, guess what? I'm sorry to disappoint you, but all your cars are done. No, we don't want any more of your business. Let's just say I made an executive decision. Yeah. But look, you better come get these cars because as of now, you're renting my garage for $120 an hour.
Joe, this is delicious.
Eat up, buddy. You deserve it.
I never had a steak like this. It's like butter.
I know. I can't believe the Lou's boyfriend didn't finish that.
Andy's right. Never gets old.